Hello, everyone.
So today we're continuing our discussion of Unetane Tokef, which opens with the idea of awe and fear. Rosh Hashanah is framed as this terrible day of judgment when even the angels tremble in fear, and God is portrayed as the judge, prosecutor, expert, and witness all in one. Remembers all that we have done and judges each living being and determines their destiny. What follows is the most memorable part of the poem, a list of possible destinies. Who will live and who will die? Who will perish by fire, who by water? Who will be at peace, who will be troubled? That long list of fates concludes with the line, but tshuva, tefillah, and tzedakah, but repentance, prayer, and charity mitigate the severity of the decree. This one line is the focal point of the poem, in my opinion. Up to this point, it was all about the power of God, and our destinies were out of control, and this line adds back human agency. The poem ends with the forgiving nature of God and God's eternalness compared to the fragility and temporality of humans, who are compared to withering grass, a passing shadow, a fading cloud. So while the theology of Unetane Tokef, of an all-powerful judging God who rewards and punishes in due measure, may not mesh with a lot of us today, I think there can be comfort in the idea that there's something eternal beyond us, that the show goes on. And there's something powerful in admitting our limits as humans. We're not going to live forever, but we know the world will continue on after us and hope that we will have left an impression on it. And the line, but repentance, prayer, and charity mitigate the severity of the decree, is particularly powerful in a world where a lot of things feel out of our control. It adds control back. I invite you to think a little bit about what was in your control this year and what wasn't. Unetane Tokef can speak powerfully to you, and it could frustrate or upset you. Both are fair reactions. Think of the poem as a jumping off point to reflect on the turning of the year and what that means for you. See you next time.